I didn't think that I'd be able to cope. Honestly, I never thought I'd ever quit ever. Masia, I'm like, I never thought I'd quit smoking. And I didn't know it was even possible to be happy. And I didn't know how I was going to get through my life. That's how much I relied on smoking. So the fact that now I can say that I can do anything, I can eat and not have a cigarette after, I can, you know, go to a function and, like you said, appreciate just hanging out with people. It's not about cigarettes. Like, it's just about the company and having fun and enjoying that without having a cigarette. And just the fact that I can do anything without a cigarette and knowing that I quit is just like amazing in itself.
Hi everyone, this is Nasia Davos and welcome to this episode of Ask an Ex. Every Ask an Ex episode features an inspiring ex-smoker who succeeded with the CBQ method and who shares their personal experience and unique perspective on quitting smoking. The ex I have with me today joined our CBQ program and quit smoking on the 28th of February 2022, and she's here to tell you how she did it. Please welcome Sharon Pinto. Sharon, huge congratulations on your success.
Thank you so much. I'm so happy to be here and so happy to be talking to you about this and be able to tell my story. So, thank you.
Same. Of course. I am also so excited because we've been arranging this for a while and I know you've had a very unique journey. So I cannot wait to hear all about it. So can you tell me a bit more? How did you start smoking? How much do you smoke? For how long?
Interesting enough, when I was younger, this sounds maybe probably silly, but I used to like the smell of smoke. I don't know why, but I used to like it. I don't know. And, so as a teenager, you know, you're hanging around certain people and, you know, everyone's trying out these new cigarettes and, so that's basically what I did. I basically was just curious about it. And I did like the smoke for some reason. And so I tried it. And to be honest, the first time I tried it, it didn't taste good. It didn't taste good at all. I actually didn't like it. And I didn't really do it for like probably another year. And then after that, I just started hanging out with some people. And then it just... I started liking it. I started used to it. And that's kind of how I started.
Yeah, slowly, slowly.
Slowly, yeah. Yeah. And then I got addicted.
Yes. And so for how many years did you smoke? And when did you start thinking that, oh, I would like to quit smoking?
Oh, gosh. Okay. So I smoked for 29 years.
Okay.
And I probably didn't want to quit smoking until my late 30s. And I would try on and off. Like I tried patches. I tried cold turkey. Those things didn't work. And the last time I did quit, I think it was about 5-6 years ago. Mm-hmm. And my doctor had told me that I was close to COPD.
What?
Yes. So that scared me enough that I quit that day and I was done, didn't care, didn't want it anymore. It was over and I thought I was done and I went 10 months without smoking. Wow. And then all of a sudden, you know, I was hanging out with this new group. I was seeing a new guy. I was hanging out with a new group and they were always smoking. And for some reason, memories, I don't know what happened, but I was like, yeah, you know what, let me just have a little drag, you know,
right.
Into one cigarette turns into like, you know, now I'm buying packs of cigarettes. And then I just got into it again. And it's been an ongoing battle since.
And so you started slowly and you became addicted again.
Yes.
And then what made you decide again that, you know, it's time and I would like to not be smoking?
Guilt. shame. I was tired of it controlling my whole entire life, no matter what I had, but no matter what I did, whether it was after I ate, whether I was sad, whether I wanted to celebrate, whether I was stressed, whether I was happy. Like, I just had to have that cigarette. And if I ran out of those cigarettes, it was like, oh my gosh, what am I going to do now? It would just control my life, everything I did, everywhere I went. And it became embarrassing. You know, like, I didn't always want to leave a room to have a cigarette. You know, I just remember being like at my family's house. And I know my mom, you know, my mom's so not a, she doesn't approve of it at all. And I know, like, I'm old enough to make my own decisions, but I still don't like to hear it all the time, you know?
Yeah. And mom is always a mom, yeah, right?
Yeah. And it was just that embarrassment of always, you know, covering it up. I hated smoking around non-smokers. I hated it. Like, I was embarrassed. I was a respectful smoker. I always walked away and had my cigarette, but it was just, I just hated having to do that. I was embarrassed by it.
Yeah.
I mean, when I started smoking, it was more accepted. Everybody did it. You could do it everywhere. Now it's just kind of frowned upon. And I know, like, I shouldn't really care what people think, but it did weigh on me. And then I would feel guilty about it. And the more guiltier I felt about it, the more I wanted to smoke. So it was also, I felt that smoking was a comfort thing for me. I did. I really felt like whatever I was going through, it just made me feel better. I guess I looked at it as a friend at that time.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. And that perception of it as a friend is what makes it so addictive and creates that relationship. And Sharon, you said something else. You said that that you hated smoking and now it's frowned upon, and that you shouldn't care what other people think, but it weighed on you. And I think the reason you cared what people think is because it touched on something you already knew to be true about yourself.
Yeah.
Because when we truly stand by something, we really don't care what other people think. But when these opinions touch on something that we believe is partially real, that makes it, that creates the guilt, and that creates us caring about it. So
yeah, and I think I knew that, like, it wasn't good for me. It wasn't really serving me. It wasn't helping me in any way. Like, it was just that comfort stick that I thought it was, but it wasn't anything else. Like, it wasn't, you know, it was really like destroying my health and my looks. And it was actually making me more stressful to smoke than to quit. I will say that. It was just the guilt and the shame and the covering up and the hiding and that was stressful. That was more stressful.
That is huge, right? That's huge.
Yeah. And more alive now than when I ever smoked. Like, I'll never, ever go back to that ever again. I couldn't even imagine. I've already been in situations like that. And I'm like, no. Even when I see other people now, I'm like, I remember when I used to be one of those, and now I'm not. And I feel really good about it.
And what, because you tried to quit smoking many times, you had a successful quit for 10 months that you did in the heat of the moment. What made you decide to try this method, the CBQ method in this program?
It just really resonated with me. Like, the funny thing is about that was that I was actually like praying for some help with this, because I was literally like, I need to quit. I need to do this now. I'm getting older and I have to do this now. And the next day, I don't know how, I found your program. So that was,
wow.
Yeah, that was like a miracle in itself. So I was like, okay, guess we meant to be. And then I watched your webinar and I just like the whole method of how you design the program. I love visualizations and mind power. I'm all into that stuff. Mm-hmm. So it kind of just resonated with who I am as a person. Mm. And that's how I knew that it was going to help me. I just knew right away.
I love that. And, you know, Sharon, I cannot tell you how many times people have told me this thing, that you know, the prayed or the meditated on finding a solution, and then the next day or next week they came across it and they were like, this is the sign I was looking for. Love that. So tell me about the program, because, and I know we talked about it a little bit before we started the recording, but you went through the program a few times. Yeah. I want you to tell me why and how did that benefit you?
The first time I went through the program, it was amazing. Like, I was learning things. As the program got towards the end, I started to get scared.
Mm-hmm.
I started to get scared of losing my cigarettes. Now, I think I got on to six, and that started, yeah, I think it was six. I think that was emotions, right? Emotions?
Number six, yeah.
Yeah. And that's when I started to shift, but I also started to, I couldn't relate playing with pleasure was the seven. Mm-hmm. And I had a hard time with that for some reason. And considering the first time I quit was like COPD and I was like done and I couldn't find my emotional reason. And I had a hard time with that. I think you gave me some suggestions, but again, you gave me, when I did end up completing it, but then you said, you gave a list of like, if you still feel like this, mm-hmm. Wants to go back on. And I didn't do that.
Okay.
So that one, that was also during 2020, COVID. That was a really stressful year anyways. So, So what did I do? I tried again. Tried again in 2021. Trying to think what happened with that one. I think that one I didn't finish. I know that one I probably got to maybe eight or something, and I didn't complete it.
Mm-hmm.
So that's my excuse for that one. And then 2022, I was like, okay, let's just try this again. And I'm not a quitter. Except for smoking.
Yeah.
But so I tried it again and I said, you know, this time I just want to complete it. I really do. And when I got to number 10, when I got scared and you said, like, just take that leap with your skydiving story, which I've done too, by the way.
Awesome, right? So you could totally relate to the feeling.
And so I said, and I know it sounds silly, but I was like, I could do this. Like, just take that leap. Just do it. What's the worst that's going to happen? You know, like, your life's not going to be over. Like, I'm saving my life, if anything. Like,
yeah.
You know? And so I said, just do it. And I did it. And I think there's a reason for everything that happens. So, you know, some people can go through your program and finish it once. Me, I learned something new every single time I did it, you exactly. know? Exactly. And I got stronger every time I did it. You know what I mean? It just took me a little bit longer, but I did it and I didn't give up. So exactly. I wasn't going to give up, but I had this program for life. Like, you know, it was always there. There was no excuse for me not to do it again and again. So, yeah. So then I put out my last cigarette and that was it. And and here I am today.
Well,
<A free woman.
laughs> well, thank you for sharing that. And yeah, you said it, every time there is something new to learn, because we tend to think, oh, I have to do it again. But the truth is that there are always new things to notice. Even when we are rereading a book, there's always things that we get that are like, oh, was this thing there last time, but I didn't notice it because our mind is in a different space and more receptive. And I think it's, and like you said, it made you stronger.
It did. It really and helped through it. So
it's amazing. And from the things that you learned and you encountered, what do you feel helped you the most in changing your relationship with cigarettes?
You know, learning how to be, learning how to cope with my emotions was a big thing that helped me through the program. Like I said, I did that journaling stuff. I think like I used smoking as an excuse to not do a lot of things, to escape how I was feeling, also to escape doing things that I like. Like, I mean, like I'd be like, oh, well, I'll just have a smoke instead. You know, I won't go for that walk because I'll have a smoke. Like that's how important smokes were to me, you know?
Right.
And I think it just stopped me from doing a lot of things. And I think I actually wrote something to you in 2020, and it was about, I was journaling and I had this inspiration, and I think you put it on your Facebook, but privately. And it was about like, I pictured the smoke, like just kind
yes,
of.
Yes, I remember that. I remember. And I shared it with the members group, and you said yes, and I did, and they loved it. Yes, I remember.
And it was like that. It was like this, it was like the smoke was my shield of.
Would you like to share it again?
Yeah, if I can kind of remember when I say, yeah, it was like.
However, you remember it. I mean.
Yeah. So it was like when I was journaling, it just came to me that, you know, it was like the smoke was kind of hiding me, hiding who I really was and keeping me back from doing the things I really wanted to do. I used this as an excuse, as an escape to stay small instead of bringing out who I really am. And it's really weird how smoking can do that, but that's how it kept me, you know, that small. It kept me like that. I don't know how to explain it. It was, you know, it kept me hidden, I guess, in a way. I don't know. I feel like I do so much more. I'm more free. I'm more alive since I haven't been smoking.
Yeah. And you are. And I think people will understand exactly what it is.
Hope so, yeah.
Where you feel like, oh, it's something that blocks my true potential. It helps, stops me from coming in contact with who I really am, in the good and the bad, showing myself what I'm made of, seeing how far can I stretch myself, how far can I grow, and this block, this it's weighing you down. So yeah.
That's what it did for me. And I don't know about anybody else, but that was like what it did for me. So, you know, it opened new doors. So remember I said it opened new doors. It's opened new doors for me to expanding into my true self because I've been doing other work on myself. So it has really, that was the first step towards that. So yeah, I'm so grateful. I'm so grateful.
That's wonderful. Amazing.
And I encourage anybody to do it. Give it a try. Yeah, I it just opened the new doors for me, working on myself internally, as a person. You know, so I've done other programs, other personal programs, you know, then therapy. you know, just to help myself. Basically, you know, it's all about self-love and self-care. And, you know, when I was smoking, I realized I wasn't really loving myself, you know, to the best of my ability, you know, and I think like anyone who's going through this program to know not to beat yourself up or be so hard on yourself. You know what I mean? Like, we don't realize this stuff until we're ready to realize this stuff.
And what is something you were, what is something you believed about smoking, about quitting smoking, or about yourself that changed as a result of, you know, finishing this process and quitting smoking?
I believed when I was smoking that I could not be happy without my cigarettes. I didn't think that I'd be able to cope. Honestly, I never thought I'd ever quit ever. Masia, I never thought I'd quit smoking. And I didn't know it was even possible to be happy. And I didn't know how I was going to get through my life. That's how much I relied on smoking. So the fact that now I can say that I can do anything. I can eat and not have a cigarette after. I can, go to a function and, like you said, appreciate just hanging out with people. It's not about the cigarettes. Like, it's just about the company and having fun and enjoying that without having a cigarette. And just the fact that I can do anything without a cigarette and knowing that I quit is just like amazing in itself.
So you're so right. It's so powerful. So you went from believing that you cannot be happy without cigarettes, that just like you cannot see how to do life without them, to feeling more alive, like you told me before, and appreciating things for what they are and feeling great. I think that's
And I'm free,
beautiful.
like I feel free. Like I just don't have that weight on me, that hole that, oh, I gotta go get this pill. I gotta go buy cigarettes now. You know what I mean? It's just, it's a nice feeling that I don't need it. Actually, I will say this, I can't even stand the smell of it anymore.
Really?
Yep. Whenever anyone else smokes, I am like, oh, I can't. I don't like it at all.
And that's amazing because you said that you liked it when you even before you tried it, but just you have changed the associations in your mind so much that this is just, there's just nothing pleasurable about it anymore.
And I will say that when I really knew I was done, when I really knew I was done, was I think last Halloween. Because I mean, smoke was around me before, and I could have that thought of I could, but I'm not, because I'll never go back there again. But when I really, really, really knew was Halloween, and I went outside with a girl, and she was smoking, and she asked me to come with her. I was like, okay, I don't even know why I went. And I went and I watched her smoke, and she offered me one, and I didn't even want it. Didn't even want it at all. I was like, nope, no thank you. Like, I didn't, like, before it was like I could, but I know what would happen. This time it was like, nope, I don't care for it at all. And that's how I knew, like, no, I'm done.
Wow. How did it feel to say
Not good.
that?
I've never felt like that in my life.
Yes. And really you persevered. You didn't give up, truly. And I think that's so commendable because you had the one, okay, you weren't ready to push through and quit. The next time you didn't finish the program, but you went back, you did it again. Whatever happened, you went back on track, and there is no way to fail if you have that commitment. There's no way.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's so inspiring. Nothing, you didn't allow anything to
No.
stop you from doing what you promised yourself you'd do.
I was determined, and I knew your program was going to get me there. Like, I knew that that was the way to do it. I knew it wasn't to go cold turkey. I knew it wasn't to, go on patches. I wanted to do it as natural as possible, and I wanted to do it to right the right way. And I wanted, it was all mind power, right? So I wanted to do it with this. I wanted to do it with my brain and my mind and my subconscious, and I wanted to do it the right way so that I could disassociate with it.
Exactly, so you can be done. And taking to the story you shared before, that's exactly why when you quit smoking out of fear and it lasted 10 months and you somehow started but you had no idea, it's because the fear led you. And I mean, amazing that you lasted 10 months. That's incredible by itself. But you hadn't changed your thinking, so
No,
you
that's right.
didn't. And that is the difference, which is all the difference.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's amazing. I think you should be really proud of yourself. I know you are, but it is great.
Nice to hear
And
from you.
yeah. And how has your life, I know you mentioned a few things. How has your life changed since you quit smoking?
Like I said, I take care of myself now. Love myself more. Pay more attention to myself. you know, I work out. Yeah, I don't know. I feel good. I feel good. And I think what I do most is I appreciate moments more. Because with cigarettes, it was kind of like you just don't pay attention. You just kind of like you're in your own little world and you're just whatever. I don't know. For me, it wasn't like I think I enjoy moments with people more and situations. And yeah, I just think, and I'm more focused. I must say I'm more focused because it gave me a lot of anxiety. A lot of anxiety in the mornings if I had a smoke. And so I can say I'm less anxious too, actually. Oh, so that improved too. So a lot of things do improve when you quit smoking. And my breathing is actually improved as well. So, and I just joined a sport. So it's good that I quit a year ago because I would never be able to run. I'm playing ultimate frisbee.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So I just joined that. I haven't played in like 6 years. So,
wow.
So if I didn't quit smoking though, I wouldn't be able to do it.
There's yeah. No,
like I was already having a hard time breathing. That was another reason why I quit too, because I noticed and I was scared too, right? Like I was like, I always pictured that breathing oxygen machine and I was like, I don't ever want that to happen to me. So, yeah. So yeah, my quality of life is better.
Yeah. And not only physically, but I love that you mentioned so many mental health benefits. Even more. And I think that's great. That's so important because as smokers, we are terrified that our mental health will suffer. We will not be ourselves. We will feel worse. But the truth is that when you change your thinking, when you change how you think about smoking and you truly break free, you become more focused, less stressed. You become your true, authentic self. Like you said before, it's so I think it's
I know that it doesn't seem possible. Like when you're going through it, it does not seem possible. Like I was like, I don't know if I'll ever get to that point, but your visualizations also help with that. You just see yourself that way, even though it doesn't seem like it. And then you can feel your way into that. And still, I don't even know if I ever believed it until it actually happened. So, and it works. It really works. And yeah, it does improve. It probably improved my mental health more than it ever did my physical health. So.
It's amazing. It's amazing. And so what did quitting smoking teach you?
Just that it's possible. Anything's possible. You can do anything. Even if you think you can't do it, you can do it. That's what it taught me, for real. I know it's a little bit cliche, but you know what? It did. I never believed I could do it. So the fact that I actually did it was like amazing.
Yeah. Yeah. Cliche because it's
true. If I can do that, what else can I do that I think I can't do? Right?
Exactly. Exactly. 100%. This is exactly it. It becomes a point of reference that you can do other things. And then you put yourself out there more. You try stuff. Exactly. Yes. Yes. Absolutely.
It gives you more motivation to do more things.
Like yeah.
Now what else can I do? You know? So.
Exactly. Well said. Well said. And Sharon, what advice would you have for someone who they're in the process of quitting smoking and their quit date is approaching and they want to do it, they're excited, but they're also sort of terrified of failure, of pain, of everything. What would you tell them so they can, you know, follow through?
Okay, well, I went through the same thing, as you know.
That's why I'm asking.
Like I said before, I think like it's a process, and I think you need to really be patient with yourself. And I think you just need to believe that it's possible and that you can do it. And it is a process. So while you're going through it, I think you just need to be good to yourself and just follow the program and know that it's going to work. I think you just got to know, like, hey, I'm doing this because I want to do this. So it's got to work. You know what I mean? And it's not the end of the world. If it doesn't, you can do it again and again and again. You know, it's, you know, you just do it until you just don't give up. You just keep trying. Right. And yeah. And I mean, it's worth it. At the end, it's worth it.
Yes. Yes. Wow. Thank you. Thank you for sharing that. And you also, I love it. You believe in yourself, but you're also saying to trust the process, because that also matters. You can, if you chose this, you trust yourself that you chose it for the reasons you did, that it resonated, and see that through. Yes. Trust yourself, trust the process, trust the thinking that brought you here.
Exactly. Exactly what I'm saying.
I love it. Sharon, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah, for sharing your very, very interesting quit smoking journey. Your transformation was incredible. I am sure that your experience will help and inspire many others to persevere and succeed and experience that amazing transformation that's on the other side of fear.
Yes, yes. And I just want to say thank you so much. You and your program have been such an inspiration to me. Also, thank you to all the other Ask Ex-Smokers for helping me get through this that time of my life. So I just want to express how much I thank you. I love you. You're the best. And yeah, I've never been happier. So I owe it all to you.
Thank you so much. That's so sweet. And and Sharon, you know, you did it. You made it happen. You know that. I am so happy to have been of help to you. And thank you so much for taking the time and sharing your story to help inspire other people. That's amazing.
Oh, it was my pleasure. I'm so happy that I was able to do that.
Yeah, and if you're here watching this video, please leave a comment below and let Sharon and I know what you're taking away from her journey, her experience that can help you in your success. We're looking forward to reading your comments. Thank you all for being here. Have a wonderful day, and I'll see you next time.